Hello, everybody! This is Punk Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Super Mario Sunshine playthrough. Last time, we took our first steps into Level 4, Peanut Park, where we actually had some pretty significant plot revelations, to say the least. We found out that our evil doppelganger, Shadow Mario, was in fact Bowser Jr. who's behind all this trouble, which means, yes, Bowser's involved in our little story here. But we'll worry about the ramifications of that later. Also, in the last episode, we returned to Bianco Hills to get a couple more shine sprites out of there. And once again, we're going to revisit another earlier level for this video. We're going to make our return to Rico Harbor by going right over here. And let's go ahead and get started. Right, so we still have plenty of work to do here in the harbor. We have our first two shine sprites done, and actually, before we move on to episode 3, I'm actually going to claim one of the first hidden shine sprites that we're going to encounter here, and we're actually going to revisit episode 2. There's a method to the madness here. Alright, so anyone remember this area? When we last visited this place, we had to ride a blooper around the little obstacle course, and we managed to get a shine sprite. But there are actually two shine sprites you can get from this area. The first shine sprite you get by beating the timer under 45 minutes, but if you can... 45 seconds, excuse me. But if you beat the time in less than 40 seconds, you can get an additional shine sprite. So let's go ahead and see if we can beat that. We're gonna have to literally cut corners and take some shortcuts here, but this actually isn't all that bad, so let's see if I can get this done. Now, one thing I kind of picked up on is that by manipulating the camera, you can actually help the blooper make some tighter turns. You do want to be careful, though, because those of you that saw the first time I went through this part of the level, if you hit anything while riding this blooper, it's pretty much an instant KO, so you want to be on your guard. But we should have it done. Yes! Just under 38 seconds, and there's our first hidden shine sprite of Rico Harbor. There's one down for this episode. So I should go ahead and talk about the hidden shine sprites. Here's basically how the standard levels of this game play out. Basically, it is 8 regular shine sprites per level, and then there are 3 hidden shine sprites. 2 of the hidden shine sprites can be found in 2 episodes you've already beaten previously. But the third hidden shine sprite is actually the 100 coin shine. So every standard level of this game has 11 shine sprites in total. So we've got some collecting to do. Anyway, with episode 2 done, pretty much for good, now that we've collected the hidden shine sprite in that episode, let's continue on with Rico Harbor episode 3, The Caged Shine Sprite. Away we go! This looks a bit daunting because we're gonna have to do some good old-fashioned platforming, and why wouldn't we? I mean, it is a Mario game after all, and Mario didn't necessarily make his name doing platforming, but he certainly contributed to the development of the genre. Because, you know, he did start off in Donkey Kong, so he wasn't quite a platforming star when he started out, but he certainly became one over time. So basically, this mission is gonna require us to climb on different sets of grating, and we're gonna be grabbing onto moving objects, and it's gonna be quite an adventure. Although, let me see if I can perhaps finagle things a little bit here. There actually are more, there is more than one path that you can take in order to get to the Shine Sprite here, including you can actually use a special new kind of nozzle that gets showcased in this particular mission. If I don't get knocked off by other obstacles. Let's see. I'm taking quite an unorthodox route to get to where we need to go. I actually skipped a pretty significant portion of this mission. But anyway, here's a new type of nozzle that we can use. The Rocket Nozzle. The Rocket Nozzle can be found in the red nozzle boxes. And basically, build up power by holding down R, and then you'll launch straight up into the air. Now, you can actually use this to make it a little bit easier to get inside that large cage. Or you can just simply bounce on these platforms that will take you higher and higher until you ultimately reach the top. If I can't do it this way, I'll go ahead and use the rocket nozzle and actually show off what you can do with it. But it doesn't look like that's going to be much of a problem as we make it. Ah, how's that for a 10-point landing? And just like that, another Shine Sprite is ours. I apologize if my voice isn't quite what it usually is. I'm still recovering from my little hospital stay. Probably shouldn't be trying to record, but, you know, I gotta get these videos done, man. Can't leave my channel sitting idle, you know what I'm saying? And speaking of being idle, we can't screw around. We gotta go right back into Rico Harbor. Although I have to say, I'm not looking forward to this next mission. It's time for Episode 4, The Secret of Rico Tower. I've said it before, when you see the word secret in a mission title, expect bad things. And this is one of the best examples. Or perhaps I should say it's one of the best examples in the early game. But then again, in general, almost all the secret levels are, you know, they're challenging in one way or another. I did describe an earlier one as sort of a platform hell, and I do stand by that. Luckily, I think we can grab us a 1-up. Might be needing a couple of those, depending on how things go here. But now we have to make our way up to the top of this lighthouse here in order to actually get to the entrance of the secret area. If I can pull off this wall jumping section right here. Ah, not quite. I'm probably making this more difficult for myself than I need to. And here we go. Let the suffering begin. I see you there, Shadow Mario. And this is where the episode is going to go completely off the rails. I can practically taste it. So here's our daily dose of platform hell. I mean, you know, hey man, daily dose of platform hell, doctor recommended. Certainly not Dr. Mario, maybe Dr. Wario, you know, considering how nefarious he can be. Although this isn't so bad, this first part, you just gotta be careful with how you run across those rotating platforms. Let's see if I can one up and get this extra life, or wall jump to get the one up. Jeez, I can't talk. Can we make it across these cogs? No, we cannot. That was actually a good start, too. Oh, and did I mention, in these secret levels, there are no checkpoints. So have fun starting at the very beginning every single time. As if they weren't sadistic enough. Oh, and there's another twist I might be showing off later on to these levels, because you can actually revisit them with Flood. And Flood doesn't necessarily make them easier. You'll see what I mean as we go through the game. Whew, made it. All right. Take a little breather. We still got some work to do. Made it. That was not fun. I'm gonna speak truthfully for everyone for a moment. This is why I was actually kind of reluctant to try and revisit this game, because of some of these secret levels. They really are a frustrating aspect. I mean, they're challenging, yes, but I don't know. All right. Well, I say we keep going. This episode's gonna be productive, damn it. And as much as I had a rough time in episode 4 already, we're actually going to go back into it because episode 4 contains the second Hidden Shine sprite of Rico Harbor. Alright, so you may be wondering why we're coming back here. Well, there's your reason right there. Pretty much every secret stage in this game has two missions. There's the regular mission where you have to go through the whole obstacle course without Flood, and then you have these red switches. What do these switches do, you ask? Collect 8 red coins before the timer runs out. Good luck! That's right! You may get to revisit these stages using Flood, but when you revisit, you have the opportunity to do an extra twist. You get to actually attempt to grab red coins, and Flood's basically there just to make it a little more manageable. And you may think, oh, Flood is here, so it's gonna make the level easier. Wrong. Well, he does make it easier to recover if you happen to miss a jump. But that's not the main problem. The problem here is that you're on a timer, so you still can't mess around. That's the message here that I'm trying to send. And I may have messed up. Yep, I messed up. Dang it. That was more my own fault than anything else. All right. So now a second shine sprite will appear, and let's get out of here. Woo! And that is shine sprite number 20. Woo, we're really making some progress in this recording, but it hasn't come easy, to say the least. Ah, but what is happening here? It appears we have actually unlocked a new level. However, it's actually a level that we're not going to visit for quite some time. I'm going to go ahead and spoil it. We actually just unlocked, I believe, level 6. And we haven't even seen level 5 yet, so we're getting a little ahead of ourselves here. And we continue our hijinks here in Rico Harbor for episode 5, Gooper Blooper Returns. Not like Batman Returns, no. But we still have to deal with him nonetheless. And he drops all pretense on this one. He's not even hiding in boxes this time. He's like, here I am, Mario, come and get me. I'm happy to oblige. But in order to actually fight him, of course, in typical Mario fashion, we're gonna have to actually reach the boss, and that's gonna require some good old-fashioned platforming. Hope you're not tired of that, because we're far from done with it. You got something to say? I'll throw you all the way to the helipad! Thanks for the help! I have never gotten to Gooper Blooper this way before! I usually take the more convoluted way where I have to do more platforming. Huh. Well, that's a little unorthodox, but it'll get the job done. Now here on the helipad, you just saw it, Gooper Blooper has a new ability where he will sweep. He will sweep the platform in a circular motion, and he'll try to take your feet out, basically. But it's the exact same strategy as before. Basically, you pull on his tentacles until they're all gone, and then you gotta pull on his mouth. So let's see if we can actually do this. Like, other than that one additional attack and the change in arena, this fight is almost identical to the first one. So it's basically just a rehash. Not the biggest fan of boss rehashes, but that's how it is here. And once again, collision detection being a bit weird, trying to pick up that tentacle. Come here, boy! And now for the big one. Yeah! Had to hold that one. But of course, much like our first encounter, there are two phases to this one, and it's the same strategy again as the first go-round. If I can just grab a tentacle, I'll go ahead and settle for that one. Or that can happen. That can indeed happen, where you will drop off if you're not careful. Luckily, we do have the rocket nozzle to take us back up to the top. So let's go ahead and try this again. Or that could also happen. And it doesn't help that there's damaging goos in the water below, so you need to watch where you land. Alright, come on. This is gonna be done right. I don't normally have this kind of trouble with this guy, but definitely having to fight this time around. Alright, nice little combo going on right there. Just need to get him one more time. This might do it! Okay, let's finish this off once and for all. You are going back where you came from! Go terrorize somebody else's harbor. Alright, so that took a little, that gave us a little bit of a problem, but we managed to get it done. 21 Shine Sprites down. We have collected 5 in this recording alone. Despite some mishaps, this has been very productive. Which is what I need. I need a good productive episode after not having updated this playthrough for well over a week. Gotta get back to work. And we're gonna finish things off with one more mission. Rico Harbor, Episode 6, Red Coins on the Water. Not smoke on the water, but we'll go with it. And we could definitely be running into some problems with this one. Oh boy. I remember when I did my first playthrough of this game, I had a very bad experience attempting this mission. Hopefully it goes a little better this time around. So it's another red coin mission, and once again, it involves the bloopers. Red coins before the time runs out. You have 2 minutes to collect all the red coins, and it's not that difficult, but some of the red coins can be in some pretty precarious spots. Luckily, there is a path to getting around the harbor and collecting all the coins, unless you miss one like I just did. But luckily, the gold coins will be your guide, so be sure to follow that. Alright, we should just have to worry about one more. I got over a minute, so I should be okay. I just need to be careful. That was a bad time to cut away. Oh, thank goodness. I wasn't going too fast. I was about to say that camera cut away, and I was like, oh no, this is bad. Let's see if I can stick the landing, baby. That was not what I wanted! Oh no, no! Where am I going? Where am I going? This was not a good blooper to pick up. That's one problem. You can leap for the shine, and you'll end up hitting the blooper on the dock instead. Or you can just flat out hit the dock itself and fail miserably. Okay, let's try this again. Maybe I should try lining up myself here. Aim for the gap, and... Woo! Thank you! I had a bad feeling when I had that first failure. I was thinking, oh no, is this a sign? But nope, only 2 attempts. Because I was actually careful this time and didn't try to rush. I actually took the time to line myself up properly so I wouldn't fail. Whew! What a recording for this episode of the Super Mario Sunshine playthrough. Let's go into our totals. We definitely made some progress in Rico Harbor. We have 6 main shine sprites as well as 2 hidden shine sprites. And we're well on our way to possibly finishing that level very soon. However, we're actually going to take another break from Rico Harbor after this video, and we're actually going to focus on some of the other levels that we still have to do. And in particular, we're actually going to return to Bianco Hills in the next recording. So with that is going to do it for this episode of the Super Mario Sunshine playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.